Tremendous, terrifying shape slithered from the shadows. The snake's body coiled around the forlorn like a scaly shield. It looked like the crystal could be turned, but the handles were retracted. Within the cage was a crystal prism, once bright, but now dulled. It didn't fit, and wouldn't work as a lever. Hidden inside was the Wanderer's journal. Alone, I searched. I swallowed hesitation. And at last, the doorway opened. But beyond, there was nothing. I did not understand. The stranger was so lost. curling and coiling, lost forever. The stranger looked at Ember with relief. I tried to go back, but I just went nowhere. Time to go forward, I think. Inside was a secret diary entry. And so it goes. We try, we fail. There is nothing more. Home is not as I wished. Hope? Do not believe in false hope. The light acted as a beacon, drawing the snake away from the forlorn. Ember swallowed their fear, feeling tiny before the enormous serpent. The forlorn was released from the coil of the snake's body. Stranger's thoughts bubbled up freely. The invitation was clear. Some thoughts were easily found. Some thoughts only whispered. old feelings in a complex tongue. Stranger had much to consider. The stranger seemed grateful. I think I have to choose for myself. The ghost said, "Speak, and I will listen." The path ahead lies behind that door. Do you wish that I open it? Know that if you return, you will always be welcome. Warm yourself, little one. Time is to be saved. ghost said, speak and I will listen. Take the water to the east. In an open corner, a forlorn lies unmoving. Spindle was missing a handle, so Ember couldn't turn it. Tremendous, terrifying shape slithered from the shadows. The snake's body coiled around the forlorn like a scaly shield. A lost message was inside. The embers rush past in a blur. They must not know what awaits. Poor, foolish little embers. A few trip and falter, grasping for a reason to stop or turn around. Thank you. Ember found a secret note from the Wanderer. A few embers flock together. Together we linger. Together we could be a beacon. A lighthouse. The stranger's heart was in knots. Some faded memory. With tears, the stranger said, "You have reminded me, friend, the beacon." The light acted as a beacon, drawing the snake away from the forlorn. Ember swallowed their fear, feeling tiny before the enormous serpent. The forlorn was released from the coil of the snake's body. The stranger had been robbed by an icy hand. They had burned so bright, so brilliant. With flicker and ash, their flame had faded. The stranger looked at their hands tearfully. I had forgotten how warm it feels, just being. Ghost said, "You have done all you can, little one. Your journey lies ahead. Your journey is nearing its end, little one. You have cleared a path for others to follow. I will guide them after you have gone." Only the Forest King knows where the final campfire sleeps. Ask them your questions. Know that if you return here, you will always be welcome. Fresh air was welcoming as Ember left the caves behind. The forlorn was different. A gentle music filled Ember's thoughts. They sang. I was Ember. I was bird. I was forlorn. None were my true self. I will not go back to flame nor feather. I will find another way. Ember understood and let them be. Something was wrong. Ember could feel it. It was quiet. All the birds had gone. There you are. You've done this. The king is gone. Gone. What did you do? Telling lies, being tricksy? We had no troubles till this one. The king is dead. Dead! They'll be coming for us now, all of them. Who looks after us now? What does we do? I'm not a real bird, just wearing bird clothes. They're not even a real bird. Who look after them now? The forest king wasn't moving. The Forest King wasn't moving. chains and pulleys in the base of the chair. It didn't feel real. The Forest King wasn't real. Broken boats were scattered on the water. The ghost spoke. Brave little one, few have made this journey. This is the last campfire. Your path ahead is clear. What you do now is yours to decide. This is the end of the path. You have helped all who can be helped. It is time to complete your own journey. A boat lies waiting, but it belongs to another. Their path was not so straight as yours. Seek them out before you move on. In the clearing, Ember hoped to find answers. Behind the Forest King's puppetry was the wanderer in the red cloak. A stranger spoke. Why didn't you stop? Why not stay safe in the nest I made? Don't you see? This is all there is, just the end. What hope can there be in that? The stranger had dropped their mask. Ember knew they spoke the truth. The path goes nowhere, but we sail on regardless, slipping beyond the horizon, one after the other. I couldn't bear it. In the end, I destroyed the boats. What have I done? Slowly, the stranger withdrew. I wanted to be a lighthouse for others. How do you save others once your light has gone out? The wanderer's thoughts had become twisted. Hiding every day behind a mask. Watching hopeful little ones arrive endlessly. Knowing the empty path that lay ahead. Inside their dim light was a hidden pain. They had watched those they care for turn forlorn. They had locked their hope away, tried to protect it. And Ember's actions had seemed a distorted mirror. The Wanderer searched for words. When I reached this place, I could see the truth. This is all that there is. There is nothing that comes after. How do you face that? I'm not ready. I turned back, tried to stop the others. Built a little nest. What a mess that was. You hope, you try, you fail, and then nothing more. I thought I was saving them, that they would lose hope if they knew. But without an end, they lost hope anyway. The Wanderer took a breath. I thought it would lead somewhere, mean something. Ember paused. So many places the path had taken them. So many others whose paths had crossed their own. After everything I've done, I don't deserve to move on. Only my boat remains. Take my oar. Finish your journey. Leave this place. Ember knew the end lay ahead. Were they any more ready than the Wanderer? There is a place where the lost embers go, as their light begins to fade.